Hey friends, you probably know that you can build and deploy your container-based apps using GitHub Actions and workflows, but did you know that you can also scan your Azure Container Registry-based container images with Microsoft Defender? April Edwards is here to show me how to apply this and other DevSecOps practices today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with April Edwards. How are you?
Doing great, Scott. Thank you for having me.
Thanks for hanging out. We're going to talk about DevSecOps. Now, I know about DevOps. I've DevOps'd all my things. I feel pretty good about my developer operations, my CI/CD pipeline working well. But now I'm realizing that I may have missed some things, and you're going to let me know what I may have missed.
Absolutely. And I think as developers, we don't want to think about security, like, ever. It's a pain point for us.
Yeah. So, I mean, I don't want to say that out loud. I was going to like, but yeah, like, it's just, it's no fun, right? It's no fun.
It isn't. Security isn't fun for a lot of developers. They want to write code and they want to think code first. So we need to look at ways that we can secure our developer environment, secure our repositories, and our CI/CD pipelines. So you ready to dig in?
Let's do it.
All right. So I'm going to go ahead and pull up my screen here. I have a repository that I've configured. Now, I can easily select any file in this repository and pull up an editor. And that's great, but I can't run any testing or debugging tools. I can't access any of my extensions. I can also get this down into VS Code locally on my machine, but as a developer, it takes so much time to get started on a new project. And all I want to do is code. So we need a secure environment. So here we have GitHub Codespaces. So I can go straight to my code here, where in the past I would have cloned my code locally to my machine. I could have had that repository ready to go. We could have set up a dev container locally. That still takes time to get going. But the problem I have is, as a developer, maybe my machine can't handle, you know, trying to develop code and run those testing and debugging tools locally. I just don't have the compute, or maybe, you know, I'm limited by my sysadmins or whatever it is in my environment. So I'm going to spin up a GitHub Codespace, and the GitHub Codespace will allow us to kind of have that consistent experience across all of our developers. And it's super easy to set up. I can set up faster than I can even make a cup of coffee, which is more than I can say about cloning a repository. So I'm just going to pick a 4-core, 8-gig RAM code space, and I'm going to spin it up and let's see what it pops out. So It's going to connect this code space for us, and I can have on-demand development with it.
Right. And this is using the same technology behind dev containers. That container just is in the cloud in this case. And you can see right there, it just said container built. So it's using that .dev container. Oh, look at that. It's already up. Okay.
And it's ready to go. And the cool thing is, I can open this up in my local VS Code with the exact same code spaces connectivity. So I'm still coding on my machine. And, you know, if I wanted to do that and have that same experiences. So, Yeah, it's still setting up. Now, it is setting up the terminal because, again, that takes compute power. So it's getting everything configured. The cool thing is, I can go in and I can run and debug my code. The other cool thing is, Scott, and you know, maybe you and I are working on a problem together, I can go into my live share and configure live share to go run. So I can share this session out with you and we can share my dev container, or I can join another session. So we have all this ability in the cloud in a sandboxed environment, secure and ready to go.
Okay. So how does this dovetail with security and DevSecOps?
So one of the big things we have to look at is, you know, when we're working in a highly performing DevOps organization and we want to, you know, do that shift left and secure things early, this is a good way to secure our developer environment straight up. So instead of looking how we secure our machine, we can spin up this environment. We have that continuity across all our developers. So that whole, this doesn't work on my machine, can go away.
Good point. Good point. Okay. That makes sense.
Yeah. So we've secured our code. I can access my code here. Not a problem. Now, we secure this developer environment, but then once I push my code, it's going to go into my repository. So let's look at some ways to actually secure our repository. So if I go into my repository here, you know, we've spun up what we've done in our GitHub code space. I can look at a lot of other things. Now, I can also look at how we want to secure this. So there is a security tab here in GitHub that is in every organization and in every repository. So you can look at configuring things at the organizational level or repository level. So I've already set up Dependabot here. It takes some time to scan all my code, and Dependabot will find all the dependencies in my code and pull out some of the alerts and may find some issues with the code that I have. The other thing I can set up is a code scanning alert. So to set up code scanning, We just select it and it sets up a workflow for us. So we select that, it writes us a workflow and it injects it into our actions. So I've already created a workflow where we've set up this secret scanning in our repository. Now, this has failed in my existing repository because it's found errors in my C# code. And when it sets up that workflow, it knows I'm using C# and JavaScript in my repository. So we're scanning our repository for these things. It also supports other languages, which is really important because not everyone's going to code in the same language.
Okay, cool.
So the other thing we can set up is secret scanning. And I think all of us as developers have done this. We've put a password or connection string somewhere where we probably shouldn't. So when the secret scanning piece is enabled in our GitHub repository, we can then look at getting those notifications set up automatically. So it goes to the administrators in private repositories, or it sets up alerts in Azure as well. So this all hooks into Azure, which is really, really cool. So we want to look at other ways we can secure our repositories. So we set up our developer environments. We want to set up how we then do our CI/CD. So I have a workflow here that has already ran. So something else I've done to secure my environment is I've set up different environments within GitHub, because I'm not just going to deploy straight to production. I'm deploying to my developer environment. And when I look at what I've deployed here, I've built and tested my code. I've pushed an image to my Azure website to Azure Container Registry. I've also deployed it to a test environment. But as I've deployed it to my Azure Container Registry, I could add in a bit of code here that lets me scan all my images in Azure Container Registry pretty easily and pretty quickly. And I can get the results here. The results actually output here, but I need a more detailed report. I need more traceability as part of that DevOps process, because we can secure that repository, but what if we push code or images that aren't secure? So if I hook into Azure, I can go and pull up Microsoft Defender for Cloud and very easily see where all these recommendations are. So as I push new code in my repository, it's going to push through that workflow and it's going to come up to the Microsoft Defender recommendations. So I can go into my recommendations and remediate the vulnerabilities that are sitting there. So I can see that I have container registry images in my pipeline that have pulled through that have vulnerabilities. So this is really important, Scott. We need to secure what our developers are doing as part of DevSecOps. We need to look at the whole picture for them, just how they write their code, where they commit their code to, and use those tools that are easy to enable within our GitHub repositories. And then when we run those CI/CD workflows, we need to be able to hook that into our Azure App Insights and all the tools built into Azure to give us that output in that full DevOps lifecycle, adding in that SecOps for not only our developers, but our security operations teams.
Interesting. I'm curious, in your opinion, where do you see the relationship between Dependabot, which we see in GitHub, and Microsoft Defender for Cloud, which is more kind of operational? Dependabot seems to catch things on the check-in and looks for vulnerabilities and known packages and things like that, while Defender for Cloud in Azure seems to catch things more on the binary side as it's about to go into production.
Absolutely. So when you have that DevOps process in your organization, when you're submitting your code into that repository, you want to catch things early and often. So Dependabot, I can click on the alerts that I have in my repository, shows me where I have low severity, moderate severity, and high severity. So these are catching things at the source. And we hope to remediate these things before we push them up into Azure, into our code. And that's super critical. You can also see where it scanned my code, which is really great because CodeQL allows us to scan that code as we submit it every single time. That means as a developer, I'm not just submitting code and catching it after the fact, because we know that when we catch those things in production, not only is it massive vulnerability to our organizations, but it also costs more to those organizations. So this tells me I have clear text logging of sensitive information. I need to remediate that immediately.
Very cool. Very cool. So both of these things, both Dependabot and the security tab, specifically the security tab in GitHub, and Microsoft Defender for Cloud, are both something that I could potentially put on my systems right now. People who are watching can enable this today.
Absolutely. So if you go into your GitHub repository and go into that security tab, you can enable those right away. For those of you who want to enable Microsoft Defender in Azure for your CI/CD workflows, there's a great article on docs.microsoft.com to get you started. And it only takes a few minutes, because when you configure it, it spits out a YAML file for you to add into your existing workflows.
Very cool. All right. Well, thanks so much for hanging out today.
Thanks so much, Scott, for having me and talking about DevSecOps.
All right. I am learning all about how to build secure apps with collaborative DevSecOps practices with April Edwards today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.